with the first chapter of general chemistry, that is some basic concepts of chemistry. I will begin this chapter by giving a brief introduction regarding the matter, what is chemistry, etc. So, as you know, you have come across the term matter in your school level, right? What is matter then? Anything which has mass and occupies space is called as matter. Matter can be seen or its presence can be felt. Whatever you come across in this universe is made up of matter. Then how to define chemistry? Chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the composition. This whatever kind is structure, properties and interaction of matter. In simple terms, chemistry is the science of atoms and molecules. Right? So chemistry is the science of atoms and molecules. Before going to the further details of this chapter, you should know why at all should you study chemistry. What is the importance of studying chemistry? In the previous class, I have told you cannot imagine a single day without using a chemical compound, right? So the very basic needs of human beings, that is food, shelter, clothing, they are nothing but chemical compounds, the organic compounds or inorganic compounds. If you come to the basic need, food which is consumed in the form of either carbohydrates, proteins, oils and fats, vitamins, etc. All are organic compounds. Coming to shelter, we use iron, we use cement, etc. All are inorganic compounds. And if you come to clothes, both natural fibers as well as synthetic fibers, they are all organic compounds. Apart from these, in the treatment of various diseases, chemical compounds are used. To quote a few examples, two important compounds, cisplatin and Taxol, they are used in the chemotherapy of cancer. Chemotherapy, therapy indicates treatment, chemo indicates chemical compound. So the chemical compound used in the treatment of cancer, they are cisplatin and Taxol. Another important invention is that of AZD, which is called as azido-thymidine. Now this compound azido-thymidine is used in the treatment of AIDS, a dreadful disease, the long form of which is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Now you have come across refrigerants which are responsible for depletion of the ozone layer in the stratosphere, that is CFCs, which are nothing but chlorofluorocarbons. Safer alternatives have been found out by researchers for these refrigerants, that is chlorofluorocarbons. So continuous research is going on to reduce the miseries of human beings or in general in society. So students, if you have an interest to continue your studies, higher studies in chemistry, you can go to the research field and find something new which is helpful for serving and saving the society. Hence the study of chemistry becomes very, very important. Now let us move to the nature of matter. Now matter can be broadly classified in two ways. The first classification is physical classification of matter, and the second classification is chemical classification of matter. Let me begin with the first category, that is physical classification of matter. Now coming to liquids. Liquids have definite volume but not definite shape. They take the shape of the container in which they are placed. For example, if I take water in a beaker, so they take the shape of the beaker. Examples for liquids, water, milk, oil, etc. all are all liquids. Now coming to the third physical state, that is the gaseous state. Gases neither have definite shape nor have definite volume. They take the shape of the container in which they are enclosed. Remember, gases are always enclosed in closed containers. Example for gases, air, oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. are all gases. Now, a very important thing which you need to remember here is that the three physical states of matter, solids, liquids and gases, they are interconvertible. Conversion is from one form to another form. Interconversion will be coming back from the other form to the original form. So if I take three states, solid, liquid, gas. So this interconversion can be brought about by altering, that is changing the conditions of temperature or pressure. Let us see what will be the effect of temperature on the three states in which water is present, H2O. So in the solid state it is ice. What happens when you heat ice? The symbol for heating is a triangle. Remember this, if at all on the arrow there is a triangle, it indicates heating. Ice, which is the solid, on heating is converted into the liquid water. Water on further heating is converted into the gaseous state, that is water vapor. Now the other way, if you cool water vapor, what will be formed on cooling water vapor? You will get back the liquid state, that is water. Water on further cooling will give you the ice. So therefore, the three physical states of matter are interconvertible by altering the conditions of temperature. This is one particular example to explain the concept. I hope physical classification of matter is clear to you. The second classification of matter is chemical classification of matter, about which I will be discussing in the next class. I will stop here.